This Headless Professor video is about how to use JASP with a very large file in a CSV format to answer some hypotheses. We begin by launching JASP. It has this icon, so we'll click on that. And we're going to begin by opening a file. Open. And on my computer, I have a file that I've downloaded from the city of Chicago. And it's about Chicago sex offenders. Now, I've eliminated their names and their place of residence. And now I have a total of 6 variables in rows and columns. Notice my first row in the CSV file was about the label of the variables, and my next rows were for data, and I have a total of 1,071 cases of data. Now notice that JASP has already figured out that some of these variables are in nominal scales, whether the victim was a minor. Some of these are clearly ratio scales, like age and weight. It assumed that height was in a nominal scale. Actually, this is an ordinal scale, the way it's set up here. So we're going to change that by clicking on it and using this icon to indicate it's an ordinal scale. Okay, the first thing I want to do is to get descriptives on each of my variables. So I click on descriptives and I select all 6 of my variables. Notice how JASP immediately does the calculations over on the right. And let's suppose I want to see some plots and I want some frequency tables. It'll immediately do all of that. So, for example, it turns out that of my over 1,000 subjects, 3% were female and 97% were male. The average height was about 5'3". Of course, this is a mean and really should be using a median here, but the height range from about 5 foot to about 6'8". Those were the extremes. In terms of weight, it ranged from a low of 100 pounds up to over 500 pounds with a mean weight of 187 pounds. Also breaks down the ethnicity of the offenders in the city of Chicago, and it seems like 29% were with minor victims, and 71% were with adult victims. And it already gives us the scales. Notice how the height comes very close to a Gaussian distribution. Weight is skewed to the right by a few very heavy individuals. So we have all that information. We can cut and paste to download it. There's another way to download any of these tables or charts. Just go right over here and click on frequency. Suppose we wanted to download that table. Click on that little triangle here, and you can copy very easily to your clipboard and then paste it right into a Microsoft Word document or a Google Docs document. Let's suppose you have the hypothesis that most perpetrators who had minor victims were male. Let's test that hypothesis. We'll go into frequencies, and let's take a look at contingency tables. Our row will be determined by the gender of the offender. And the column will be determined by whether or not it was a minor victim. And let's see. Let's go ahead and show chi-square with a continuity correction. And let's show column order like that. Let's show our percentage across the rows. And let's see what we have over here. This would show us that we really don't have a significant relationship between these two variables, the predictor variable of gender and the criterion variable of whether or not we had a minor victim. 84% of the female sex offenders had a minor victim. About 70% of the male offenders had a minor victim. Now, that is a difference, but not a significant one. So we could not reject the null hypothesis here. That's how JASP works. I want you to try it on these data and write an abstract.